precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold.
Our prayer neighbor, Duane Seaman, has been called to report to God, the commander of us all.
In the Oklahoma hills where I was born, many a page of life has turned, many a lesson I have learned. I feel like in these hills I still belong. Way up yonder in the Indian Nation, I rode my pony on a reservation in these Oklahoma hills where I cowboy's life is my occupation in these Oklahoma hills where I was born. But as I sat here today, many miles I am away, in the place I rode my pony through the draw, where the oak and flapjack trees kiss the playful prairie breeze, these Oklahoma hills where I belong. My pony on a reservation, these Oklahoma hills where I belong. Way down yonder in the Indian Nation, a cowboy's life is my occupation, these Oklahoma hills where I was born. Well, as I turn like a page back to the land of the great Osage, in the Oklahoma hills where I was born, where the black oil rolls and flows, and the snow white cotton grows, in these Oklahoma hills where I was born. Way down yonder in the Indian Nation, I rode my pony on the reservation, these Oklahoma hills where I was born. Way down yonder in the Indian Nation, the cowboy's life is my occupation, in these Oklahoma hills
where I was born. Yeah, these Oklahoma hills where I was born. Let us pray. Eternal God, supreme commander of us all, Lord of the far-flung battle line, to whom the ranks of life report, we bow before you with reverent hearts and in sublime faith, knowing you lead us on in death as you have in life, for again you have ordered a legionnaire to the realm in the west, beyond the twilight and the evening star, where beauty and valor and goodness dwell forever with the unnumbered multitude. Mindful of service nobly done, you have called Duane to everlasting rest. You have sealed his lips with the faded blossoms of springtime and with the withered leaves of autumn. You have called Duane to eternal peace, to the land of your silent mystery. Hear now the sorrows of those who mourn. Touch their tired hearts with healing. Protect them with your holy care. Keep clean and bright in memory the splendid flame that now has flickered out, and shelter us with your compassion. Lord of all life, who lives forever, again you have taught us the measure of our days. We are strangers with you and passing through this world as our fathers were. Our days are as a shadow, and there is nothing abiding, but you abide. Your years fail not. You never change. 1,000 years in your sight are but as of yesterday when it passed. And as a watch in the night, the grass withers, the flower fades, but your word endures forever. And therein is our help and hope. You heal the broken in heart and bind up their wounds. Comfort your people. In their sorrow may there be no bitterness, no doubt of your eternal goodness. Give them to know you do not mock us with this dumb and hope of life eternal, that having created and cared for us, you will not desert us to the dust, that you hold with us an unloving, with a loving unfailing, and that our dead are you are keeping, and you are able to do far more for them than we ask or think. Until for us also the day breaks and the shadows flee, grant us to live so our lives may honor the legionaries who have gone before us. Together we may come to the city which you have prepared for those who love you and keep your commandments. For your own name's sake, we pray. Amen. It says, O God, who heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds, look in tender pity and compassion upon thy servants, whose joy has been turned into mourning. Leave them not comfortless, but grant that they may be drawn closer to thee, to one another by their common sorrow. Fill the souls with the light and comfort of thy presence. Grant unto them such a vision of that light wherein all mysteries shall be revealed, and all fear be wiped away, that they may be able to endure. So dwell with them, be with their God, until the day break and when the shadows flee away, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
I plead, my steps are growing wearier each day, but still I got a journey on my mind. The lures of this old world have ceased to make me want to stay. My one regret is leaving you behind. But if it proves to be his will that I am first to go, and somehow I'll be feeling it will be. When it comes your time to travel, likewise don't feel lost, or I'll be you see, and I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan. I'll be sitting drawing pictures in the sand, and when I see you coming, I will rise up with a shout and come running through the shallow waters, reaching broad as trembling hands and failing eyes. So I'll just rest here on this shore and turn my eyes. Until you come, then we'll see paradise. And I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan.
Seaman, 89 of Walker, passed from this life on December 2nd, 2017, at home, surrounded by his loving family. Born on March 8, 1928, in Vernon County, Ontario, Wisconsin. He was the firstborn to Claude and Leah Seaman. The family farmed in Hay Valley and later in Winchell Valley, Wisconsin. After high school, he attended the University of Wisconsin for 1 year before enlisting in the United States Army. He served for 18 months in the Korean War. Being the war was over, he then returned and finished 3 more years at the university. He then became an industrial engineer. On May 30th, 1953, Duane married Darlene Mortensen at Mount Pisgah Church in Ontario, Wisconsin. They lived in several different states before settling in Walker, where he farmed for 45 years. He was a member of the American Legion Raid Post 376 in Walker for 44 years. Survivors include his loving, devoted wife, Darlene, daughter, Mona, and Roy Blair of Walker, and son, Dale, and Annette Seaman of Silver Bay, Minnesota. He had 4 grandchildren and 11 great-grandchildren. Jeremy, Kelly Ryerson, and children Kylie, Kaylee, Kelby, and Barry Dean. Jennifer and Kenneth Ryerson Mims, and children Dalton, Gabriella, Olivia, and Kinsley LaRue. Megan and Dakota Blair, and child Jersey, all of Walker. And Brittany and Stephen Van Arsdale, and children Maya and Stephen of Cedar Rapids. Along with many nieces and nephews, and many others who thought of him as grandpa. This moment is sacred with the almost visible presence of Duane and others who have gone before. We come to honor the memory of one who offered life and service for God's country, one who is now enrolled in that great spirit army, whose footsteps cause no sound. But in our memory, their souls go marching on. Proudly, we remember their service in times of war and in times of peace. Because of them, our lives are free. Because of them, our nation lives. Because of them, the world is blessed. May the ceremonies of today deepen our reverence for Duane. Let us not cloak our memory of Duane with thoughts of sorrow. Tears or words of sympathy cannot bring back the comfort of those loving hands, the gaze of those crystal clear eyes, or the music of a voice still. The solemn pride of that service is his, and for the living to remember. Family and friends, let us pledge ourselves anew to united service, to consecrate and sanctify our lives, to help and protect those left behind. We realize how futile mere words are to express our deep and abiding sympathy in your loss. May you feel Duane is at rest and in endless peace. Generation after generation, all the shadowy peoples of the past have lived as we live, perplexed and mystified by death. They have gone into the great beyond with hearts filled with wistful longing, as all must go. Surely there is an afterlife for all who have been loyal and true, a life to which light and peace shall come, where the burden shall be lifted and the heartache shall cease, where the love, the hope, and the fulfillment that escape us here shall be given to us to be ours forever.
Man, who is born of woman, is of a few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth as a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not.
Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live. Even though he died, whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. I died. Behold, I am alive forever. And I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you also will live. Almighty Father, into your hands we commend your child, Duane Seaman, in hope for resurrection to life eternal. Blessed are the dead who live in the Lord. Henceforth, blessed they, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them." Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. We ask this all in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
family ask that you all join in for food and fellowship downstairs.
How many times have you heard someone say, if I had his money, I could do things my way? But little they know that it's so hard to find one rich man in with a satisfied mind. Once I was waiting in fortune and fame, everything that I dreamed for to get a start in life's game. But suddenly it richer by far with a satisfied mind. Money can't buy back your youth when you're old, or a friend when you're lonely, or a love that's grown cold. The wealthiest person is a pauper at times, compared to the man with a satisfied mind. When life has my time has run out, money can't buy back your youth when you're old, or a friend when you're lonely, or a love that's grown cold. The wealthiest a pauper at times, compared to the man with a satisfied mind. When life has ended, my time has run out, my friends and my loved ones, I'll leave them. But there's one thing for certain, when it comes my time, I'll leave this old world with a satisfied mind.
Pray, Lord, we just pray that this will be a good time of remembrance. Now bless this food to our bodies. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come stop your crying, we'll be all right. Just take my hand. Safe and warm, this bond is
gold.